A reminder to all crew members, there is only one toilet on the ship. We've reached HRS-1084, Captain. It's emitting a very weak docking signal. I almost mislabeled it as normal etheric static.
There's a generator somewhere? Sure are a lot of charging auto.
I see you have activated your holographic shroud, Captain. Excellent. Becoming indistinguishable from an authentic UDL trooper will prove advantageous to your current situation. A UDL vessel has been tracking our position and just recently docked with the station. They are patching into the station's transmission lines now. I cannot stop...
I've been waiting for this day since we tagged your ship in Cascadia, Captain. Wait, who are you? No one told me we had security forces deployed on the station already. Roger that. Just as a precaution, I'm sure you won't mind if we turn on the station security systems. Can't be too careful. We'd hate to leave this location undefended after a close call with outlaws. That should have been fixed by now. As you say, we'll just head out then. Safe travel, soldier.
The UDL gunship is undocking from the station. They appear to be departing into space.
Nice. I've never been great at de-escalation.
keep an eye on the floor.
Subjects. They're still alive.
It's done.
Now, let's go get our money before SubLight sees what a creepy dump this place is.
Chartrand is that scientist, right? From Cascadia?
Easy.
Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship. We've arrived at the Groundbreaker. Captain, I wish to offer my commendations for convincing the UDL's gunship to leave HRS-1084. I did not favor the idea of being stripped and sold for parts.
I shipped with a merc who had a gun like yours, Nyoka. He polished it, sang to it, slept with it. Not like that. As far as I know.
Sounds like he had himself a discerning pally. Where are you going with this?
He couldn't hit the broadside of an assault cruiser, hence the tin shredder.
Wouldn't be the first man I met bearing compensation for his lack of skill.
Finally, a base of our own. Soon we'll have eyes on every corner of the system. Well done, Captain. I'll have those dismantled. You can never be too careful when moving into someone else's territory. Aside from the automated security, did you meet any resistance at the station? I knew it. They've been shadowing us since Monarch, maybe even longer. I've been less than honest with you. Your assignments weren't strictly about the salvage business. You might have figured that out already. After the Monarch job, I started connecting the dots. I didn't like the picture. Then what we found at Station 1084 confirmed my fears. You and I have stumbled onto something big, something none of us were meant to know. Glad to know it, Captain. Ask yourself why a skeleton crew was studying that Alta Vitae gas in secret. Ask yourself why stockpiles were hidden on a planet full of monsters. Before we go any further, I want you to keep an open mind. Can you do that for me, Captain? Aliens. I'm talking about aliens. They're the ones responsible for the deaths at 1084, and who knows what else. We have to put a stop to it. Hear me out. I'm saying it's aliens. I'm not asking you to like it. I'm not even asking you to believe it. But I need to act on this threat to the colony, and I can't do it alone.
Well, at least she doesn't expect us to believe it.
Right. I'm done. I'm officially tuning you out until such time as I hear the words payment and or shooting.
The crew is skeptical. That's good. I don't want you walking into the unknown with blindfolds on. I assume you have questions? If we're gonna see this through, I'll need your trust and commitment. Now's the time for setting doubts aside. Conspiracy. One carried out with the help of human collaborators, assuming they haven't all been replaced. This is an invasion of our very cells. That damned gas is mixing our nucleon with Halcyon biology to twist us, change us, make us more like those monsters on Monarch. No kidding. That's how they want it. When I lined up the evidence in my spreadsheet, there was only one possible conclusion looking back at me. This is my data talking, not my anxiety or lack of sleep. Sharing my findings took a calculated risk. If you were a spy, I doubt you'd even realize it. Only your cells would know. Probably nothing to worry about, as long as you don't start growing tentacles or slowing down time. If you don't believe me, go pay a visit to the puppet master who's working against her own kind. Dr. Chartrand is the crooked psychopath behind the gas experiments. She sold out her species, and I need you to put a bullet through her skull. She's a research scientist and a damn good one. Before UDL poached her, she engineered a 0.2% increase in cysty pig juiciness. Now she's doing the same thing with humanity. Her fingerprints were all over Station 1084. You saw what she did to her team. It's cute that you'd think that about me. I just want to add savior of humanity to my resume. I've got ambitions outside of this office, you know. Besides, this way SubLight gets first dibs on alien salvage. We're far beyond theories. Chartrand's logs, the gas, the suspension tanks, how much proof do you need? Wake up, Captain. An invasion needs collaborators working from the shadows. She has access to the board, unlimited funds, and a colony full of sheep. Do you usually come across innocent people trapped in suspension tanks? Because some of us would call that excessive. Remember, the tanks were just the shit she left behind. Just imagine the experiments she carted off to her next lab. Don't think for too long. I want this business tidied up before anyone starts asking questions.